9/11 Museum provided insight on the attacks on the country's freedom and provided greater detail than what we are taught in schools. I learned about Ladder 3 and the firefighters who gave their lives saving others.
So my biggest takeaway was we hear about things like this in other places all the time, bombings, attacks. So before I went to the 9/11 Museum, I always had this thought of like, this is just one thing that happened to us. Why do we make such a big deal about it when it's happening all over the place, around the world? But getting to see the gallery of everyone who died and pictures of them and how people remembered them really showed me what an impact emotionally it had on our country in terms of something like this had never happened before, and it was so catastrophically important that it really changed how our nation looked at the rest of the world and at ourselves.
So what I would ask people is, what do they know about the people that did it? I would want to learn more about why, like what created the circumstance for people to want to harm people, and how we can apply that to our lives and just make a better world for everyone.
I like the history exhibit where it showed the timeline of 9/11. So from, I think, 8 o'clock all the way up to 12, it's been showing all the news, showing firefighters helping literally all of New York was just helping together, and it was really cool to see.
What I learned about bravery from the 9/11 first responders is that when the event was happening, it was felt all around the country, and citizens that were not involved wanted to just come and help because everyone's lives were just impacted just in that moment. And they risked their safety, which made their help all the more appreciated to everyone.
So what I took away from the 9/11 Museum was I didn't really understand why they picked the World Trade Center, the Pentagon, and the World Congress Center, or the World, the Congress. And I found out through the museum that they picked the World Trade Center because of economics. It was a symbol of the United States economics. They picked the Pentagon because it was a symbol of the United States' military, and the plane that ended up crashing in the field was headed for Washington, D.C., which probably would have meant it was for political.
During 9/11, everyone came together as a group. There was no regards to race or gender or age. Everyone was just working together, and it brought people together to help others, because in the scheme of things, we're all just humans, and that's how 9/11 has like sort of helped us to connect more, and it's also helped us to be safe. And the people that came together that day, it was just incredible.
So I saw this plaque about a dog named Sirius that had passed away, waiting for his owner to return from rescuing people. And it made me cry so much to think about the fact that this impacted so many people, and then to go and see each individual person that actually passed away, and to think of this as this wasn't just a thing that happened to a bunch of people. I got to see each face of who passed away, and it was very emotional and very surreal, and to know that this changed so much and made such a difference was extraordinary.
The question I still have is, how many people were in the buildings at the time of the 9/11 attack and survived, and also how many people of those who survived were saved by the immediate efforts of emergency personnel who risked their lives and went to the buildings to save them?
So my main takeaway about this museum is it really made me realize how it happens and how tremendous it was. Before, I was born after this happened, and I always heard about it and didn't realize how hard this was and how horrible it was until I saw this exhibit. And I remember going up to one exhibit, and it had recordings of people that called the people that died in 9/11, and it had their recordings of messages that they left behind, and it was really hard to hear, and it made you feel the pain of those people that experienced it.
One thing that surprised me about the bravery of all the first responders was that after seeing all of the destruction that occurred on 9/11, there was such hope and goodness in all of the selfless acts that the first responders did. Remember, one of the stories was that these two firemen would not leave a burning building until they got their friend out, and they were there for hours upon hours, and then they finally did it. It was just a great story of human compassion, and there were so many like that. And I think that's one thing that people really need to know about the stories about the first responders. They were true heroes, they were selfless, they were willing to risk everything to help someone else.
Alright, so you can already see how security is changing in airports and stuff like that. You can see how where they pat you down, they take more precautions, and there's more restrictions on how you can, where you can pass through and where you can transit. And it's really like a lockdown security. And ever since 9/11, it's been just like so secure. They won't let any sort of dangerous weapons through, so nothing like this could happen again.
One exhibit that impacted me most was the exhibit where people didn't know what was going on. They saw the other tower get hit, and then suddenly they get hit. People in the other tower were unsuspecting. They were wondering what was going on. There were calls to people at home that they saw it, and they saw the plane heading towards them, then the calls cut off. The people that lost their lives were unsuspecting, and they just didn't deserve to die that way.
My favorite exhibit was, there was a black room that you walked into, and it had screens on both sides as well as chairs. And when you walked in, what it did, it was a light board, and it showed like personalized images as well as descriptions about the people that died that day. And it also, they showed interviews of people, of like the family members and friends of the people that that knew the people that died. And it was kind of surreal to take each member of the big 3,000 that died, and you put like each person had a life, and like they had people that they meant something to, and that's why it had the biggest impact on me.
In the future, I think that people will continue to be just as careful, especially even more careful, with security and regulations as they are now, because 9/11 really changed a lot when it came to security in like airports and background checks on people, and especially now that we live in a much more digital age than we did in 2001, cybersecurity will also become a bigger concern.
The 9/11 Museum taught me a lot about what I thought I already knew. One of the biggest impacts was when I went into this room that showed us more about the lives of the people that were impacted, not only of the family members, but the people that were actually in the buildings. I think the result of 9/11 was very severe on America. We will definitely be focusing more on security, and I think that's very important, especially now that technology is also becoming more prevalent in our daily society. I just think it's important to protect America in order to prevent this from ever happening again.
In my opinion, the main impact on 9/11 Museum was how tragic it was. There's one museum where I saw people falling out of the building. I just thought that was just insane because of two airplanes that flew into the towers. 9/11 was one of the most tragic events in United States history. It will forever be remembered. I just think we can do better to better America after this and go into the future.
Well, my main takeaway from 9/11 was life is short, and make it to what you want it to be. And things happen, unfortunately, in the world, things happen, like 9/11 happen all the time. So enjoy your life and, make sure you leave a good legacy. Make sure you have something good you remember by.
So the main thing I got from the museum was how many people collaborated in the darkest of all to help everybody in that area. The firefighters came in, even though they knew that it was going to crash. Everybody around New York decided, hey, we need to help them as much as we can. and that really affected me.
All the people that helped others escape, like the first responders, firefighters, and even regular citizens, they were being heroes because they were brave enough to enter the building to save others when they knew that there was a possibility that they could have died too.